Well, good morning, everybody. This is Gary doing a presentation on the ANZTB conference that I attended last night. The ANZTB conference is the Australian New Zealand Software Testing Organisation. You can find their website by just doing a Google search. Anyhow, the conference was interesting that I attended last night. There was well over 40 people in the conference, and I attended with Gordon Sanderson, who is helping me with the advocacy work that I'm doing, and he also is helpful in trying to get software testing happening here in Brisbane. The conference was organised by Marie Walsh, and of course the conference covers both Australia and New Zealand in terms of software testing. Anyhow, at the conference, I learned about more terminology in relation to software testing. I mean, I'm going in there from the deep end. I don't really know exactly too much about what is involved with software testing, but it gave me more of an insight of what actually is required. I heard about what is called a scrum team, which was referred to where a group of persons who are software testers work together within the organisation, and their responsibility is to test the software for thoroughly, and they have a sort of a supervisory role, which has often five testers in a team, and it's under a supervision of one particular person, etc. So I learned more about this. I had the opportunity to do some networking, which for a person on the autism spectrum is particularly challenging. But it was great that Gordon Sanderson could take me along, because it took away a lot of the strain of having to get there and feeling anxious, etc. I'd also like to mention that I have put forward an expression of interest to be a casual software tester, which means that I'd be doing this around my current employment. The idea is that it's not about me. The idea is that to be able to start software testing and to be able to get and provide an opportunity for adults on the autism spectrum to be able to become software testers eventually. My meeting this last night sets the very early framework for a possible organisation to be structured here in Brisbane. Of course, this will take some time. I would like to look specifically at the way that the scrum team is so formulated, and to try and make this more of an Asperger-friendly, autistic-friendly sort of structure. Of course, this is something that would need a lot of time, dedication, etc. I also heard about what is called a test plan sprint, or a sprint test. Now, this is another thing that I'd like to find out about in terms of what is actually involved in this procedure. Is there some sort of requirement to means test the software, etc.? So, all I can say in conclusion is that by going to the meeting last night, which was in Brisbane, is that it's laid the foundations for the early stages and planning in terms of getting software testing happening here in Australia. As you know, that there's nothing here. I can say that in the United Kingdom they have Autism Works, they have Specialist Erno, and in Denmark they have Specialist Erno. In America, they have Aspiratech. Australia, there's only the sort of experimental software testing somewhere in Melbourne, which I'm not really getting any information about at all. I don't even know where it's going or what's actually happening, or whether it's even still receiving funding. That's through the info exchange in Melbourne. But I would like to see software testing happening here in Brisbane, because I think it also centres the Australian-New Zealand market. And for any adults on the autism spectrum in New Zealand, and I know that there are some, I would encourage you to attend the ANZTB conference in Wellington and to get yourself known there. This would particularly relate to Connor Lampard, who's in New Zealand. He may have the opportunity to go there and attend a conference or whatever, or any of the other adults on the spectrum in New Zealand. So it's open to you guys if you want to have some participation, which across the Tasman would be ideal, because I can't do everything on my own. I need the help of others. we could really get some things happening happening here. So that's what's sort of more or less happening. I've also heard from Gordon as well, who contacted KJ Ross and Associates, and unfortunately there isn't really a great deal of tolerance at this stage in terms of understanding the spectrum. So we need to keep our fingers crossed, and let's see what happens with software testing.